Did you drop something, Latham?
No, I didn't have anything to do with it.
Pick it up. I don't think it's quite what we were looking for, Miss Bennett.
Lizzie, we've only got a couple more minutes.
Can't leave now. I'm just getting warmed up.
I reckon it's about time you and me had a little talk. Just to show you I don't bear grudges. Not even against sewer rats. Now sit down. Where are Ros and Lizzie? They should be finished by now.
I haven't seen them.
Oh, good. If Lizzie blows this one, I'll... How'd your end go? Is she giving him the letter? Well, why not?
Because I didn't give it to her. Well, I couldn't. She brought along the barrister who's going to look after Davy and me. Anyway, it wouldn't have done any good. Angela went to see Herbie again. He wouldn't even talk to her, Bea. He even said if she kept pestering him, he'd tell the police she was forcing him to lie.
Oh, great.
So you went all through that for nothing?
Oh, I don't know. We caught ourselves a stoolie. Vera's little lag. Now, maybe if we'd been able to get that letter out
Stop
in time...
Stop it, Bea. You're not going to hurt her.
After what she's done? Pat, it was the only way I could get to work in the laundry, honest. You've got to believe me. I didn't mean to hurt you. Sure. I've got to get something for the kid out of this.
I know.
Maybe keeping you in one piece isn't such a bad idea after all. Yeah. Next time you see Vinegar... You're going to tell her we're not on to you.
She won't believe that.
Well, then you'd better make her. Yeah, I reckon we can use you. What do you say, girls?
You mean sort of like a double agent?
Yeah, why not? Only we feed Vera what we want her to know. But in return, we find out what we want to know.
Yeah, good one.
How about it? After all, Pack can't keep tabs on you forever.
Latham?
Ah, hello, Miss Bennett. Oh, it's nice to see a smiling face. You know, I've always said you had a sense of humour.
Outside. I'll wipe that grin off your face one of these days, Smith. That's twice you've made a fool of me, Latham.
It wasn't my fault, honest. It was a joke. They were having a go at me, see? Look, I did all right the first time, didn't I? It's just going to take time to get them to trust me. It's a wonder they're not onto me already, the way you went barging out there, the Sarvo.
You've had it, Latham. After this afternoon's little epic, I don't think I'll have any trouble in convincing Mrs. Davidson that you should be moved back to maternity, permanently.
Oh, give us a break, Miss Bennett, please. That letter thing, it was just a setup to get you out of the way. They're on to something bigger.
Such as?
I don't know yet. I know it's got something to do with Lizzie and Ros, though.
Coulson. And if I know Birdsworth, this better not be another one of your little tricks.
Honest.
You shouldn't have taken so much, Lizzie. I've pushed everything around so there'll be no gaps. They'll never miss it.
Anybody sees us dragging this thing around, they're going to know what's going on and they're going
to... I'll just say that we pinched too much start. I was just saying to Ros, it'd be nice to have a good strong arm around to help us push this back in the laundry.
I think the governor's going to be quite so quick to trust you now, Coulson.
She never did nothing. I made her help. I said I'd break every bone in her body if
she
didn't
help. Shut up, Lizzie.
That's no way to speak to a lady.
No, don't.
Let me go. Let go of me.
Come on.
Mr. Fletcher.
He hit me, Mrs. Davidson. He hit me.
Yeah, that's right. I saw him, Mrs. Davidson. He was like a wild thing, a real brute.
I'd never laid a finger on her.
I think we can believe our own eyes, Mr. Fletcher.
Give me roses. I wish he could again. that was on the outside, and things were different then.